Hey y'all, Nicole Telkish here from the Wildflower School, and I am here to talk about our Materia Medica, the plant of the week. It is yarrow or Achillea millifolium, and that is the Latin Achillea millifolium. It's in the Asteraceae family, and it is a very potent plant that is extremely useful in so many ways. So let's just look at the virtues of yarrow for a little bit. And I was looking for the perfect specimen for you and I could not find it, so I kept waiting to do this video. But I got a few little ones so that you could take a look at it, even if they're not perfect. But the yarrow is a plant that has so many uses. I could probably spend the next hour talking about it, so I'm going to try to condense it into under 10 minutes so that you can do other things today besides listen to me talk about plants. So this is part of a series I do every week on a different plant, and you can look at our YouTube channel for more videos on other plants, or our Instagram has it too. So Wildflower School of Botanical Medicine. And this is one of our most prominent allies as far as we have a couple of allies at the school that we kind of have our primary allies, I would say, we spend a lot of time on, and yarrow is definitely one of them. So I wanted to make sure and share it with all of you because it's done so much in so many ways for me. So let's start with its actions. So some of the actions that yarrow has is that it is a bitter, it is astringent, and aromatic. So what does that mean? A bitter plant can be used internally for digestive complaints. You may have heard me talk about some of the other bitters that we've had on the show. And this is primarily known for its astringent capabilities more so. It's gotten kind of famous for its astringency because a very strong astringent is called astiptic. And astringents, what they do is they're wound healing. They kind of tighten and tone tissue together and then pull it together. They bind the proteins on a cell surface, and then they help with any kind of weepiness or inflammation or any kind of, let's say, bleeding. So a strong astringent is called a styptic, and this is a very, very strong styptic. So some would have called this the plant for the wounded warrior, which I definitely resonate with. There's so many ways that you can use this for wounds and injuries, not just physical ones, but emotional and spiritual ones as well. So on the physical level, this leaves and the flowers are collected, and I like to actually dry the leaves and flowers and then powder them and sprinkle the powder on wounds to help heal wounds. And it's very effective, very potent, even helps with certain kind of stings and bites a little bit, not as well as some other plants, but this is definitely one that you could try. And you can chew it up as a spit poultice too, but because it's very bitter and aromatic, it doesn't taste that great to do that. So you might just want to powder it and sprinkle it on wounds instead, and it's very effective that way. So how else do I use this plant? I like to, as a bitter aromatic, this is a good alternative. And it actually, because of its warmth as well as its cooling ability, which I know it's weird, plants do more than one thing. They have multiple layers. They have lots of different constituents. But this is bitter and aromatic, so it's also known as an alterative. Can be helpful to the gut, but it can also help you to sweat. So a lot of times yarrow will be used in cold and flu remedies when somebody has a fever and you want to get the fever out. Instead of suppressing it, you push it out through helping the person to spike the fever a little bit through the warmth and then push it out through the skin and help them to sweat it out. So that aromatic diaphoretic capability of this plant make it very important in cold and flu remedies. So you'll see old remedies that include yarrow. Again, doesn't taste that great. So it works, but just be prepared. It's quite bitter and quite aromatic. So A lot of times this will also be used. What's kind of magic about this is it's a tropho-restorative for the cardiovascular or circulatory system, I should say. So it can stop bleeding topically. If you're bleeding too much, it'll stop it. But if you take it internally, it can actually bring on the menses and create more excretions and more promotion of fluids internally, especially with regards to, you know, boggy menses. So midwives or parteras will use this both internally to help with bringing on menses or externally to help with any kind of tears or issues that happen through the birthing process where there's a lot of bleeding. So this is a very strong styptic, astringent, stopping blood, but also helping to tone the circulatory system and help the vasculature to be stronger and more efficient with the blood. So I've seen this personally firsthand when I had a head injury and I had a big old goose egg in the back of my head, and I took a bunch of yarrow and literally the blood started draining, because that's like an internal bruise, right? And the blood started just draining out, my lymph swelled, and the goose egg was gone within 12 hours. So, and then it just kept draining. So as far as blood goes, this is going to move the blood through the body better. And this is important also, it has implications for the current pandemic, because there's a blood kind of relationship that the virus has. So I'm curious about that. Yarrow might be an ally there as well, especially because it also helps with the fever aspect. So this is something that is definitely in my medicine cabinet all the time. Maybe not looking that beautiful alive right now, but it's definitely something I pull a lot for anytime I'm going to be going out into the field or a wild space. I'll have some yarrow powder on me. And this is also something that has been used for pain and inflammation. So if there's a lot of times you'll find old remedies that have used it for toothaches. That's generally the root that was used for that. But the parts that I most often am using internally fresh would be the whole above ground parts as a tincture or as a wound healing ointment or powder or even spray topically. So you can just spray it on things. Now, the other one, before I get into another hour that I could talk about this plant, love it so much. I want to just kind of touch on its more esoteric and spiritual ways that this plant's been used. And, you know, so it's a very protective plant. It was one of the things that physically, it was the number one wound healer on the battlefield in World War I. They pulled yarrow immediately to treat somebody's wounds. But I also see this as a wound healer for people's spiritual and emotional wounds. So I like to use it in an essence form, especially to protect you on the psychic level. If you're walking into a space that has a lot of noise that really overwhelms you, this is an essence form, which is different from herbal medicine. In flower essence form, this is something that I would use to help me to ground myself, separate my vital force from others, and really be present in my body and be protected. You've also, I learned a little nugget from Margie Flint, another close friend and a colleague, and she teaches that she uses this for people who are going into into radiation treatments and cancer, and just drop dosage to protect the body at the cellular level, which has been very helpful for some of my clients. They felt like it really gave them a lot of help during radiation treatment. So that's the essence form. And I just want to clarify the difference of essence versus whole plant form. So with that, before I keep you here for the rest of the day talking about yarrow, I'm going to end with just a few places about where you'll find it and when. So it's an earlier spring plant to early summer, depending on how far north you are, but it'll be earlier in the season rather than later in your growing season when it comes to wildflowers. It's a perennial, it comes up several times. So over the years, but it blooms once a year and usually a little earlier, and you can cut back the flowers and use that and keep the rest of the plants there. It spreads quite easily in the garden. I dare say it will take over. So be careful about that. And not that I mind yarrow taking over my garden. But it is something that you can utilize a lot of times in when you have a ground cover, you need to have something that covers up a lot of a large area. Yarrow is a nice one to put in. It's also something that is misidentified as a carrot family plant. It is not carrot family. It is the Asteraceae. It's different, which you can learn more at our school about if that's something you want to be able to identify better. And it has these little tiny, deeply divided leaves that are all over it. And it likes to grow more in the full sun, maybe partial shade sometimes, but it definitely does better in the sun. And then it'll die back every year and you'll get to have a new harvest of flowers. So with that, I know I've spent a lot of time on it, but it's a big one. And I'm gonna cut it off there. If you want to know more information about yarrow, you can come and listen to us talk about it more in some of our Materia Medica classes. Have a great day. Wildflowerherbschool.com.